Hello students, welcome back into the another session of CS02 programming in C. Today we are going to conclude this particular subject by discussing the various function in the concept of file handling. In our last session we have gone through the practical discussion of the same in which we have learned that how can we store the desired input as well as the output permanently into the text file which is created by the user, and even we have learned that how system can create the file and store the data which is entered by the user. As you can see onto the screen, in this particular concept we have to learn various types of inbuilt function, where almost starts with the prefix called F, where F indicates the file handling. All these functions are specially designed for file handling and their concepts. That's why is a prefix F is given. Now in my previous lecture we have gone through the function called F open, F close, put W, F EOF with theory as well as practical. Now it's time to go ahead for the other options, for the other functions, like the first one which I'm going to discuss is F printf and F scanf. It sounds like our routine function called printf and scanf, which we have almost used in hundreds of program. The speciality of these two function is, as the prefix is given F, it works with the file handling concept only. The functionality remains same of this particular function. That means if we use printf, then this function will print label or output onto the screen, where any type of data can be manipulated. That means any type of data means the data might be of alphabets, it might be of number, it might be a combination of alphabets plus number called alphanumeric, or even it might be any symbol. So anyone or any combination of this entire list of data can be printed using a printf statement. The functionality of scanf function is like this. This particular function will read and store data into the declared variable. This particular function will read and store data into the declared variable. So same functionality is also done by the general function called printf as well as scanf. Now the next two is again similar like a printf and scanf function. Let me write it first. That is put w and get w. But there is a single difference. That means put w works like our printf statement, or you can say f printf statement. But this particular function were specially designed for only string manipulation. Again, I'm repeating my words. This particular function specially designed only for string manipulation function. String means what? It is a combination of various alphabets. When you combine one or more alphabet, it creates a string in our subject. So put w is for printing a specific string onto the screen. The next one is get w. Get w function is same like, we can say, scanf function or f scanf function. This particular function will read and store data into the declared variable. Again, I'm repeating my words. This particular function will read and store data into the declared variable. The syntax of both of these functions is common. Suppose we want to use put w, then the keyword is put w n into the bracket. We have to pass the variable which we have created. Same like this, we can go for get w. In get w, into the bracket we have to pass the variable. Next one is fsec. This is totally different and a new function which can be used only into the concept of file handling, called fsec. What is the functionality of fsec? This function will move the internal cursor at the desired location given by the user. Again, I'm repeating my word. This particular function will move the internal cursor at the desired location given by the user. For example, suppose I have opened the blank text file. As you can see onto the screen, I have created a one notepad file where there is a one blinking cursor. Whenever I start typing any content in this particular file, that cursor moves on right hand side. When I press enter, it comes down into the very next line. If I press the left arrow key, it moves character by character on left hand side. So this is actually done by the operating system. But in programming, suppose we want to do the same functionality, that means I want to move this cursor left side, right side, down side, up side, any side. then that is possible using EBCDIC. This function is very important for the university examination purpose as a theoretical part. Next one is FTEL. Again, this is specially designed for file handling concept. This particular function will display the current location or you can say address of the cursor. Even we can say this function will display current position of the cursor. Say for example, into the notepad, suppose I have written this text, and right now suppose my cursor is at this O, then what will be the position? String always starts with the character called 0, so this M is stored on 0, that means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So this O is located at the fifth position, or you can say this cursor is located at the fifth position. So that can be displayed using the function called FTEL. I hope all of you are cleared with this theoretical concept. Next is rewind. As the name is suggested, this particular function will rewind the file and set the internal cursor at the first position. Again, I am repeating my word. Rewind is a function which sets the internal cursor at the first position. Say for example, I am writing this content in my file, and suppose I use rewind, then this particular blinking cursor automatically shifts at the first location of the file, which is called as, which can be done using rewind function. The syntax of rewind function is simple. We have to use the keyword called rewind, and into the bracket we have to pass our declared file pointer. All these functions like EBCDIC, FTEL and rewind, we cannot see anything onto the screen. All these functions performs their task internally inside the system. So this is the theoretical session for EBCDIC, FTEL and rewind. Next one is FReopen. Again, this function is similar like f open function. We know that f open function opens the file in various mode like read mode, write mode or append mode. So this f reopen no doubt open the files, but the speciality of this function is without closing the opened file, it can store the data in created file and reopens the file for the manipulation purpose. Let me explain you again. F reopen performs the functionality like f open, but in f open, once the file is open, we need to close it for storing the updated content into the file using f close command. We have practically handled in my previous lecture. While f reopen is the special function which opens the file, we no need to go for f close. You again reopen the file which holds the updated content of the user which we have done into the file. That is the functionality of f reopen. Next one is remove. As the name is suggested, this particular function will remove any content from the file name given by the user. Again, I am repeating my words. Remove function will remove any content from the file which is given by the user. Next is rename. This particular function is used to change the name of old file into the new file. It is just like a rename facility which we are using in our operating system for changing the name of file without deleting the contents. Again, I am repeating my words. This particular function is used to change the name of file from old file name to the new file name. That is the functionality of rename. Let's go ahead. Already we have used about the function called FEOF, stands for file dash end of file. EOF means end of file. Next one is F error. This function is called as exception handling function which throw system generated error message onto the screen. Again, I'm repeating my words. This particular function deals with the various types of system generated error. Whenever we are writing any program, it might possible that it contains some logical errors, some predefined errors. Suppose we want to display onto the screen, if it happens, then this could be handled by the inbuilt function of file handling, which is called as FError. In all the functions which we have discussed yet, contains the common syntax, that is just write down the keyword and into the bracket pass the file pointer, which is created after the declaration of variable. That means the instruction set which makes it like this, f error into the bracket fp, where fp stands for file pointer. No doubt fp is the standard name which I am using. Instead of this, you can use your name also. There is no rule that you have to go for, we have to go for fp only. So let's continue with the other function. The next topic of discussion is fflush. The functionality of this particular function is very simple. This particular function will remove the content. I would like to change my word. This particular function will remove the old content from the buffer where the previous output is stored. That means it clean out the old output from the buffer and store fresh, or you can say the new content into the buffer. Here don't get confused about the word called buffer. Buffer means the variable which we are creating in our program. You can use any name called buffer, or you can say variable. So this fflush is used to clean the old content from the buffer variable, and it is used to store the fresh or new content in that particular buffer, or you can say the variable. Let's move on. Next one is fgetPOS. Obviously, as there is a word called POS, it indicates the functionality of giving the position. That means this particular function will read the position of internal cursor, which is set by the user. For example, suppose I have given the text called MVM College and I have instructed my internal pointer to get set onto the third position of the entire string. That could be done using fgetPos. That means into the fgetPos, once I have to write the file pointer and then I have to give the position called 3, then in this text automatically my internal pointer sets onto the third position. This M is on 0th position, 1 V, 2 M, and on this blank space this internal pointer get set and it reads the position of that particular location and inform the user for that position. That is the functionality of fgetPos. Now whatever the information is get by this particular function can be printed using sprintf. See, in our subject there are variety of flavors the printf function contains. That means we can see printf statement in different varieties, like printf, fprintf, now sprintf. After some time we'll go for snprintf function, then vsprintf function, vsnprintf function, vfsprintf function, so on. All these functions performs the same task for printing the content onto the screen, but there is some internal difference that we need to discuss. So without wasting more time, let's go for sprintf function. For that I would like to show you the functionality onto the screen. Just type sprintf function in C and have a look into the theoretical section. Now as you can see onto the screen, sprintf statement stands for string printing. Instead of printing onto the console, it stores the output on character buffer, which are specified into the sprintf statement. One simple example I have given on a very next line, where you can see that one variable called buffer with size 50 I have declared as a character array. Then into the next line, two local variables are declared with static value, like integer a is equals to 10, comma b is equals to 20, and then I have declared a one output variable called c, where it add the value of a as well as the value of b. Basically the nature of this entire declared value is integer, but using the sprintf statement into the variable called buffer, I am storing the sum of the entire digits, and then I am printing same using the general printf statement by writing the logical line called printf into the bracket double inverted comma percentage s comma buffer. You can see the output onto the screen. The output is like this: sum of 10 and 20 is 30. So this 30 is manipulated by this particular line of code which I have selected onto the screen, but this entire message with the value is printed using s printf statement by storing that particular content into the variable called buffer. This program is not that much important for university practical session. We can go for the theoretical part of this entire discussion yet. So this was all about, we can say, S printf. I think we have discussed lots of function today. Let's skip one more session for concluding the subject. I am not going to conclude this entire subject today. Tomorrow we'll conclude the session. So up to this S printf function, we have gone through the various types of topics. In my next lecture, we'll go for SN printf, VS printf, VSN printf, fscanf, VFS scanf, set buffer, set V buffer, input output operation with command line arguments, and then the subject gets concluded, and then we'll give you the important question list for the Saurashtra University examination. For today, thank you very much, students, for listening to me, and have a nice day.